summoner's bridle. The harness conjures its own dry creature, which serves the bridle's owner for 12 hours. Most summoner's bridles summon light horses, although some rare versions create a phantom steel as the spell. With 19 hit points, speed 240 feet, carrying capacity 250 pounds, and the ability to gallop across a chasm as if it were firm land for one round. Because the summoner's bridle is usable only once per day, it takes more than one such item to provide enough dray creatures to pull most land vehicles. Caster level 10th. Prerequisites: craft wondrous item, mount or phantasm steed, depending on version. Market price 12,160 gold pieces. Light horse 12,960 gold pieces. And phantom steed. Weight / Bell of Obscurity. The augmentation disguises a vehicle from curious eyes, making the vehicle appear to be part of the surrounding terrain. The glamour includes audible, visual, tactical, and olfactory elements, though it can't disguise, conceal, or add creatures. Caster level 10th. Prerequisites: craft wondrous item, manage arcana, market price 25,000 gold pieces, weight / Wind favored cells. This set of cells comes in two varieties, raising a set of lesser wind favored cells ensures that the wind speed is always heavy, 21 through 30 miles per hour, speed multiplier times 3. No matter what the prevailing weather conditions, a set of greater wind favored cells also lets the driver set the wind direction within 600 feet of the vehicle with a command word. Caster level 9th, lesser 15th, greater. Prerequisites: craft wondrous item, control winds, market price 40,500 gold pieces, lesser 67,500 gold pieces, greater, weight 600 pounds. The vehicle statistics block. Each vehicle is accompanied by a standard statistics block. Following is an explanation of its components. Size. The size of the vehicle using the same size categories as for creatures. Skill. Which skill governs control checks, followed by a circumstance bonus or penalty based on the overall quality of the vehicle. Speed. The vehicle's maximum speed in a single move. For wind-powered vehicles such as sailing ships, maximum speed takes into account the velocity of the wind. Apply the appropriate speed multiplier from table 3-2. Random wind speed to the vehicle given speed figure. For example, the speed of a keelboat is given as wind times 10 feet. In a moderate wind, speed multiplied flyer times 2. A killbot's speed is 20 feet. In a heavy wind, speed multiplier times 3. Its speed is 30 feet. Vehicles generally take a double move. They can also move at any slower speed unless noted otherwise. The vehicle's maneuverability is noted in parentheses if the vehicle has multiple methods of propulsion, such as sails and oars. They are separated by commas. The speed of a drawn vehicle depends on its drag creature, so only a maneuverability rating is given. Descriptions of many of the land vehicles include information about what sort of drag creatures the vehicle commonly uses and the maximum speed of the vehicle when it is pulled by those creatures. Overall hit point. How many hit points the vehicle has, usually for large or smaller vehicles. Most vehicles also have hardness noted in parentheses. If the vehicle has armored plating, the overall HP and hardness of the armor are given first, followed by a slash, followed by the overall HP and hardness of the vehicle itself. Bigger vehicles, such as sailing ships, have their hit points split up across different sections, so they lack the overall HP statistic. Overall AC, armor class. The armor class of the vehicle is a hull. For bigger vehicles, this number is rarely used because attacks target specific sections of the vehicle exterior. Section HP, hit points. How many hit points each 10-foot by 10-foot section has. Most sections also have hardness noted in parentheses. If the vehicle has armored plating, the section HP and hardness of the armor are given first, followed by a slash, followed by the section HP and hardness of the vehicle itself. Large or smaller vehicles do not have sections and lack a section HP statistic. Section AC, armor class. The armor class of each 10-foot by 10-foot section of the vehicle's exterior. Large or smaller vehicles do not have sections and lack a section AC statistic. Rigging. HP, hardness, and AC of the vehicle's sails, masts, and control lines. If a vehicle lacks rigging, this statistic is omitted. For dirigibles, the rigging statistic represents the durability of the balloon. Ramp. The damage dealt by the vehicle if it rams another object at maximum speed. See collisions above. Base. The size of the vehicle given as length by width. Height. The vehicle's height, not including rigging, measured from the ground to the roof for a land or air vehicle, or the water line to the deck for a water vehicle. Sailing ships also have a draft depth given in parentheses, which represents the minimum depth of water they need to avoid running aground. SA, any special attacks such as a ramming prowl. SQ, special qualities, any special qualities such as resistances. route. Not many people are required to operate the vehicle safely unless noted otherwise. One must be a skilled driver, but the others can be unskilled. Weight. The vehicle's empty weight. This is most important from drawn vehicles. Before drawn vehicles, so it's omitted for many other kinds of vehicles. Cargo. The capacity of the vehicle's hold in tons. 1 ton equals 2,000 pounds. If the weight of cargo affects the vehicle's speed, the change in speed is noted in parentheses. Cost. The vehicle's cost in gold pieces. Water vehicles. Water vehicles are built for many different specific functions, for few of which are very interesting to an adventuring group. Most adventuring takes place on or under land. So even though dozens of different styles and classifications of ships exist, from one-person dugout canoes to enormous triple-master war galleons, only a few are useful in most campaigns. Ships presented here are split into three types, based on their applicability to the adventuring party. Those on which the PCs are the main crew, those on which PCs are part of the crew, and those on which PCs can be passengers. Unless otherwise noted, those standing on the deck of a water vehicle receive 1/2 cover from most foes and 3/4 cover from attackers in the water. Smaller vessels. On a vessel of up to 60 feet in length, either the PCs or the entire crew, or they comprise most of the crew with a little help from experienced sailors who can be cohorts or hirelings. Unless the PCs hire a captain, they are in charge of the ship and usually take care of the major functions such as rowing, navigating, and minding the rudder. These types of ships usually stay on lakes and inland waterways. If they go out to sea, they rarely leave sight of land. Keelboat. Gargantuan vehicle. Profession. Sailor. +0. Speed wind. × 10 feet. Nautical good. Oars. 10 feet. Nautical good. Overall. AC 1. Section HP 40. Hardness 5. Section AC 3. Rigging 30 HP, hardness 0, AC 3, RAM 8.6, base 60 feet by 20 feet, height 10 feet, draft 5 feet, crew 15, cargo 50 tons, speed wind × 5 feet, oars 5 feet if 25 tons or more, cost 3,000 gold pieces. The keelboat can have a single light catapult or ballista mounted on deck. Launch. Huge vehicle. Profession. Sailor. +2. Speed. Oars. 15 feet. Nautical good. Overall AC 3. Section HP 30. Hardness 5. Section AC 3. RAM 4.6. Face 20 feet by 10 feet. Height 5 feet. Draft 2.5 feet. Crew 4 plus 4 passengers. Cargo 5 tons. Speed oars 10 feet if 2 tons or more. Cost 500 gold pieces. A large oar vessel. The launch is often used as a lifeboat or ship to store boat for a larger ship. Crew and passengers are exposed to the elements, and those aboard have 1/4 cover from most foes and 1/2 cover from attackers in the water. A launch converted strictly for passengers use can hold 18 passengers or double that under cramped conditions. Such a conversion increases the launch's cost to 1,500 gold pieces. Catamaran. Gargantuan vehicle. Profession. Sailor. Plus 2. Speed. Wind. Times 20 feet. Nautical pull. Overall AC 1. Section. Hit points 50. Hardness 5. Section AC 3. Rigging 30 hit points. Hardness 0. AC 3. Ram 12 die 6. Base 60 feet by 20 feet. Height 5 foot. Draft 5 foot. Crew 15. Cargo 5 tons. Cost 2,000 gold pieces. This ship, designed for ocean voyages, is common to ancient seafaring cultures such as the real world Polynesians. Its twin hulls slip through the water efficiently, but a wooden paddle keel and simple sail prevent quick maneuvers. It has no below decks. Those on board have 1/4 cover from most foes and 1/2 cover from attackers in the water. Only a tarp provided shelter from the elements, so it's a poor choice for rough weather or paying passengers in any event. Medium vessels. On a vessel between 70 and 90 feet in length, PCs are part of the crew. There's no space for passengers who don't help keep the ship in shape. The PCs might not be masters of the ship, and they don't necessarily have control over who their shipmates are or how they behave. PCs still have assigned work, but it may be less critical to the ship's operation, such as carpentry or cooking. Sometimes these ships are ocean-going, but typically they do not have the stability or cargo capacity to sustain their crew for a long voyage on open waters. They generally travel along coast or established routes. Sailing ship. Colossal vehicle. Profession. Sailor. Plus 4. Speed. Wind. Times 20 feet. Nautical average. Overall AC. Negative 3. Section HP. 50. Hardness 5. Section AC 3. Rigging. 80. HP. Hardness 0. AC 1. Ram 12 die 6. Base 80 feet by 20 feet. Height 10 feet. Draft 10 feet. Crew 20. Cargo 150 tons. Speed wind times 15 feet is 75 tons or more. Cost 10,000 gold pieces. A sailing ship has enough room on deck for 2 light catapults or ballistas. It usually uses a launch as a lifeboat, not included in the price. Longship, colossal vehicle, profession sailor, plus zero. Speed, wind times 10 feet. Nautical pour, force 15 feet. Nautical average, overall AC negative 3. Section HP 90, hardness 5. Section AC 3, rigging 40 HP, hardness 0, AC 1, RAM 8.6, base 70 feet by 20 feet, height 10 feet, draft 5 feet, crew 50, 40 rowers, cargo 50 tons, speed wind times 5 feet, or oars 10 feet. If 25 tons or more, cost 10,000 gold pieces. The longship has enough room on deck for 2 light catapults and ballistas. Its shallow draft means that it can go without a launch if need be. Yacht, colossal vehicle, profession sailor plus 2, speed wind 15 feet, nautical average, overall AC negative 3, section HP 40, hardness 5, section AC 3, RAM 8D6, base 90 feet by 30 feet, height 10 feet, draft 10 feet, crew 20, cargo 30 tons, cost 30,000 gold pieces. This vehicle is a pleasure ship for royalty and extremely rich merchants. Much of the below decks area is given over to opulent staterooms, and the decks and castles are left as clear as possible for the owner to stroll about at leisure. Everything about the ship is the finest quality, from masts to belaying pins. Ironclad, colossal vehicle, profession sailor plus 0, speed oars 10 feet, nautical average, overall AC negative 3, section HP 30 through 30-60, hardness 10-5, section AC 3, RAM 20.6, base 80 feet by 30 feet, height 5 foot, draft 20 foot, crew 80, 60 rowers, cargo 2,000 pounds, cost 30,000 gold pieces. Ships. There's sailing ships, warships, longship, launch, keelboat, galley, catamaran, gnome, submersible, dwarvers who go to war at sea. Dwarves who go to war at sea, unprotected by flimsy wooden hulls. Dwarves who go to war at sea feel unprotected by flimsy wooden hulls. Therefore, dwarf ship rights developed the ironclad, an iron-plated warship that sits low in the water and brims with ballistables. Ironclads are rightly feared by naval commanders. The ballista crews can fire their bolts from behind protective iron shutters, breaking an ordinary ship's hull without fear of retaliation. Rowing dwarves work in teams, turning giant cranks to propel the ships. The ironclad has enough space to accommodate 8 ballistas, usually mounted 4 to a side. Gnome, submersible. Colossal vehicle. Profession, sailor, +2. Speed, oars, 10 feet. Nautical, poor. Overall, AC, -3. Section, HP, 90. Hardness, hardness 8. Section, AC, 3. RAM, 6 die, or 6d6. Base, 7 feet by 20 feet. Height, 10 feet. Draft, 10 feet. Crew, 70. 60 rowers. Cargo, 20 tons. Oars, 5 feet if 10 tons or more. Cost, 80,000 gold pieces. Gnome, submersive, can travel the ocean depths, ascending and descending through the use of a complex series of diving fins and air bladders. It can remain underwater for 24 hours at a time, after which it needs 30 minutes at the surface to recharge its air bladders. In addition to its horizontal movement, the ship can freely ascend or descend 10 feet per round. The vessel is entirely enclosed. Only a 10-foot square deck is available when the ship is on the surface. A single airlock allows access to the undersea world when the vessel is submerged. Large screws cranked by teams of gnomes propel the vessel. For game purposes, this counts as rowing. Larger vessels. Vessels of at least 100 feet in depth have enough space to carry passengers or hide stowaways for quite a while. If the PCs are in charge of the vessel, they have a major responsibility along the lines of overseeing a keep or a temple. Otherwise, the PCs are only a small portion of the crew with many crewmates and varied job roles. Many of the ships can go out to sea for weeks and are excellent for long trading voyages or warships. Barge, colossal vehicle, profession, sailor, -2. Speed, oars, 5 feet. Nautical, clumsy, or drown, clumsy. Overall, AC, -3. Section HP 50, hardness 5. Section AC 3, RAM / base 100 feet by 40 feet, height 10 feet, draft 10 feet, crew 10, 40 rowers, cargo 100 tons, cost 6,000 gold pieces. A barge is a flat-bottomed, usually rectangular boat designed for hauling cargo along inland waterways. Barges are usually simple affairs. Some are no more than glorified rafts, although they can be up to 200 feet long. The larger ones usually sport an enclosed space like a little building on one end of the ship with cots, a table, and chairs inside. Smaller barges in relatively shallow water are usually pulled along by rowers. Galley, colossal vehicle, professor and sailor, -2. Speed, wind, times 15 feet, nautical poor, oars 20 feet, nautical average, overall AC, -3, section HP 80, hardness 5, section AC 3, rigging 160 HP, hardness 0, AC 1, RAM 18 die 6, base 130 foot by 20 foot, height 20 foot, draft 15 feet, crew 200, 160 rowers, cargo 150 tons, speed wind times 10 feet, or oars 15 feet if 75 tons or more. Cost 30,000 gold pieces. A galley has enough flat deck space to accommodate 3 heavy catapults or six ballistas or light catapults. War galleys generally convert much of their cargo space into passenger space for soldiers. See vehicle augmentation above. 8 to 10 launches would provide 8 to 10 launches would provide enough lifeboat capacity, although many galleys have few. Warship, colossal vehicle, profession, sailor, +2, speed, wind, times 15 feet, nautical average, oars, 20 feet, nautical good, overall AC, -3, section HP, 100, hardness, 5, section AC, 3, rigging, 80 HP, hardness, 0, AC, 1, RAM, 15B6, base, 100 feet, by 20 feet, height 20 feet, draft 19 feet, SA ramming prow, crew 260, 80 rowers, 160 marines, cargo 5 tons, cost 25,000 gold pieces. A warship can accommodate 2 heavy catapults, or four light catapults or ballistas. 4 launches are used as light lifeboats and troop transports, not included in the price. Air vehicles. Flying vessels are generally mistrusted by the masses with good reason. Most of them are rickety contraptions, and the consequences of failure are drastic. However, creating a stable flying machine is an all-consuming quest for many gnomes who are the forerunners in the field of non-magically powered flight. Members of other races sometimes find their way into the world of experimental engineering, but only gnomes seem to have an inborn knack for. The gift of Carl is, as some sages call it. Air vehicles maneuver just as flying creatures do, climbing and diving according to their maneuverability rating. None of the vehicles described below has any bases in medieval or Renaissance reality, and almost all rely on magic for life, for lift, or propulsion. Hang glider, large vehicle, profession, pilot, +0, speed, fly, 30 feet, 4, overall HP, 20, hardness, 5, overall AC, 4, RAM, 2.6, base, 5 feet by 15 feet, height, 5 feet, crew, 1, cost 300 gold pieces. The big wedge-shaped wing consists of this big wedge-shaped wing consists of a rigid frame with canvas, animal hides, or some other light, sturdy covering spread tightly across it. Unlike most flying vehicles, a hang glider cannot ascend under its own power. Hang gliders rely on either a high launch point or thermal updrafts to gain altitude. A hang glider's pilot gains one half cover behind 1 inch of wood and cloth. HP 10, Hardness 3. Ornithopter, large vehicle, profession pilot, +2. Speed fly 40 feet, 4. Overall HP 20, Hardness 5. Overall AC 4, RAM 2 dice 6. Base 5 feet by 15 feet, height 5 feet, crew 1. Cost 4,000 gold pieces. Air vehicles are zeppelins, dirigible, hang glider, ornithopter. A magically enhanced version of the hang glider, the ornithopter relies on animated wings to propel a small character through the air. Thus, it can ascend like a flying creature with poor maneuverability. Like the hang glider, the ornithopter gives its pilot one half cover behind 1 inch of wood and cloth. HP 10, Hardness 3. Zeppelin, colossal vehicle, profession pilot, -4. Speed, fly, wind, times 20 feet. Clumsy, overall AC, -3. Section HP, 30. Hardness, 5. Section AC, 3. Rigging, 200 HP. 0 hardness. AC, 1. RAM, 4d6. Base, 40 feet. By 10 feet, height 10 feet, crew 10, cargo 10 tons, speed wind times 15 feet, if 5 tons or more, cost 60,000 gold pieces. A zeppelin relies on hot air trapped in a massive balloon for lift. The animated propellers for propulsion and animated propellers for propulsion. Because it flies, it is light in weight and vulnerable to wind conditions. Thus, it's treated as a wind-powered vehicle even though it doesn't have sails. The balloon that provides lift is segmented so that one puncture isn't disastrous, unlike creatures with clumsy maneuverability. Zeppelins have no minimum forward speed, and they can hover if they are turned into the wind. Dirigible, gigantum vehicle, professional pilot, -2. Speed, wind, times 15 feet, clumsy, overall AC 1, section HP 30, hardness 5, section AC 3, rigging 100 HP, 0 hardness, AC 1, RAM 2d6, base 30 feet by 10 feet, height 10 feet, crew 6, cargo 5 tons, speed wind times 5 feet if 3 tons or more, cost 35,000 gold pieces. A smaller version of the Zeppelin, the dirigible, also trellies on animated propellers to push it through the air. Wizards sometimes build dirigibles to ferry important underlings from place to place. Like Zeppelins, dirigibles have no minimum forward speed, and they can hover if they are turned into the wind. Land vehicles. Land vehicles range from simple carts or wagons to sophisticated war machines and specialist tools. Carriage. Huge vehicle. Handle animal plus zero speed, drawn, poor, overall HP 90, hardness 5, overall AC 3, RAM 4 dice 6, base 15 feet by 10 feet, height 10 feet, crew 1 plus 5 passengers, weight 400 pounds, cargo 500 pounds, cost 500 gold pieces. The carriage is essentially a fully enclosed wagon designed for passenger comfort, not cargo capacity. The driver and a passenger riding in front have one half cover behind 1 inch of wood, HP 10, hardness 5. Inside, passengers get three quarters cover. Two heavy horses harnessed abreast pull most wagons at a speed of 35 feet when fully loaded, and 50 feet with only a driver and passenger. Cart. Large vehicle. Handle animal plus zero speed. Drawn. Four. Overall HP 30, hardness 5, overall AC 4, RAM 4d6, base 10 feet by 5 feet, height 5 feet, crew 1, weight 200 pounds, cargo 500 pounds, cost 15 gold pieces. A cart is open top, so the driver and any passenger gain one half cover behind 1 inch of wood, HP 10, hardness 5. The most common dray creature for a cart is a mule, which can pull the vehicle at a speed of 20 feet, even if it's fully loaded.